So good morning to everyone. In today's class, we are discussing about extension of range in PMMC instruments. PMMC instruments. PMMC in the sense, permanent magnet moving coil. We are familiar with the acronym, permanent magnet moving coil. And second thing is, PMMC instruments is strictly used for measuring of DC current and DC voltage, respectively for DC ammeter and DC voltmeter. So here in today's topic, what is the main objective means? How can we extend the range of PMMC instruments? So that means how instrument range can be improved. What are the various procedures and what are the process involved in what are the various process and what are the procedures involved in this type of complexity? There are various techniques involved in extension of range with respect to an instrument, whether it may be a PMMC instrument, whatever it may be, the MI instrument or whatever it may be. So in today's aspect, we will focus our discussion with respect to that, how can we extend the range? So if we see there is an ammeter, it is having a range of reading 5 amperes. How can we extend that range of the ammeter? It can read up to 10 amperes, 15 amperes or 20 amperes. That means how can the range of a DC ammeter can be improved? How can the range of a DC voltmeter can be improved? So what are the techniques involved? Okay. And what are the process involved? All are those things we will discuss in today's class. So in today's class, we will discuss about the concept of extension range with respect to DC ammeters. DC ammeters, there are various techniques involved. So in that techniques of extension of range, one of the important technique is application of shunt resistor. This is one of the primitive method. And second one is evolution of multi-range ammeter we will discuss about. And we will discuss about universal or Artron shunt with respect to the ammeter, DC ammeter, PMMC instrument extension range. And second thing we will discuss this, it is the DC voltmeter's range extension with respect to the concept, that is multi-range voltmeter. How we can make a multi-range voltmeter by extending the range of an existing DC voltmeter. And next we will also discuss about an additional concept, that is loading effect of voltmeter. If time permits, we will switch our discussion with respect to with respect to moving coil instruments introduction, operating principle and all, if time permits. So we will discuss this today. This is very, very an important and crucial aspect. Extension of range in a PMMC instrument with respect to DC ammeter. DC ammeter, the first one is DC ammeter. So the application of shunt resistor, one of the first important application with respect to extending a range of an existing ammeter. That means how can we extend the range of an ammeter means by applying a shunt resistor. Shunt resistor in the sense, placing a resistor in across to an working ammeter. So that see in this particular circuit, I placed an additional resistor which is having a resistance rating of R suffix SH. The current flowing through the resistor is I suffix SH, and the current flowing through the total line is I. Okay, so current flowing through the total line loop is I, and current flowing through the meter, this is nothing but actual meter. Diarsonal movement in the sense, the instrument diarsonal movement in the sense, the current sensing mechanism in which the DC ammeter is used, either it may be a DC ammeter or DC voltmeter. So diarsonal movement in the sense, it is a current sensing mechanism. So whenever the current passing through the coil in the presence of the magnetic field, it experiences certain force. Okay. And this force causes the torque of this force causes the torque, and the spindle will rotate with respect to the needle will read from initial position to final position. So this entire aspect is nothing but called as diarsonal movement. So this entire thing is called as diarsonal movement. So here the current sensing mechanism is nothing but diarsonal movement. Okay. So I placed the external resistance. That means since the coil windings of a basic ammeter is very small in light. Okay. We already discussed in the construction of a PMMC instrument. PMMC instrument, especially a DC ammeter or DC voltmeter, the scale is uniform. But coming into the DC ammeter, So this is it will read even very minute small amount of currents. So how when we are having an application or when we are having a requirement with respect to the measuring of large amount of currents, that means DC ammeter will read very less amount of current, very small amount of current. It is having that unique capability. The scale is uniform. DC ammeter can read very small amount of current. But when there is an application with respect to the reading of large currents, when the DC ammeter, there is an application with respect to it has to measure large amount of currents. What we have to do means we have to use an external resistance such that whenever this external shunt resistance, see in this circuit, whenever the external shunt resistance is connected, the ammeter current carrying capability will be improved. By connecting this external resistance, the ammeter current carrying capability can be improved. So how that current carrying capability is improved? Okay, what I'm saying here, while applying the shunt resistance in a DC ammeter PMMC instrument, the current carrying capability is improving. Initially, DC ammeter of PMMC instrument will read very small amount of even it will read very small amount of current. When there is an application with respect to measurement of large current, I am placing an external resistance. By placing this external resistance, entire instrument of DC ammeter current carrying capability or current measuring property is improved. That's what I'm saying. So how is that happened means we will see that while calculating the resistance, while calculating the current rating and resistance rating. So overall current flowing in the line is capital I. Okay. And current flowing through the resistance is I suffix SH shunt current, and current flowing through the meter, that is d Arsenal moment with respect to the meter, that is I suffix M. Okay, what is d Arsenal moment? The current sensing mechanism. So whenever the coil is placed in the presence of magnetic field, it will experience a force, and that force creates a torque to move the needle. So that is called d Arsenal moment. The entire current sensing mechanism is called d Arsenal moment. So this is the current, that is about current description, and the resistance of the shunt is R suffix S, SH, and the resistance of the meter is R suffix M. Okay, that's what we analyzed here. That's what we analyzed here. That's what we analyzed here. R suffix M is nothing but the internal resistance of the meter, and R suffix SH is nothing but resistance of the shunt. Okay, and I suffix M is nothing but current through the meter, and I suffix SH is nothing but current in the meter. Okay, so actual total current flowing in the meter is capital I. So this is nothing but we involved a current division rule. So total current I is flowing in the line, it is divided into two parts. One is current flowing in the shunt resistor, that is I suffix H, and current flowing through the main meter, that is I suffix M. Okay, so from this particular current division, if we need to find out what is the amount of current flowing in this particular, what is the amount of current flowing in this particular resistance, that is I suffix SH, that is equal to current flowing in the shunt resistance, that is equal to total current flowing in the line, that is I minus IM. Okay, so if we see across the voltage drop across this this resistor and this meter, voltage drop V is equal to IR, that is V is equal to ISH into RSH, that is equal to voltage drop across this meter, that is V suffix M is equal to IM into RM. So from that resistance, actual resistance, external shunt resistance rating RSH, that is equal to IM into RM divided by SH. Okay, what is the value of ISH? ISH is again I minus IM. That means here the shunt resistance which we placed in this particular meter, the shunt resistance which is placed in this particular meter, okay, shunt resistance placed in the PMMC instrument is having a higher range of temperature sensitivity. Higher range of temperature sensitivity. And that means whenever this resistance is having a higher range of temperature sensitivity, it can hold very large amount of currents. It can hold very large amount of currents at a particular low resistance value. Okay, so mostly this external shunt resistance that is made up of a magnesium material or copper material, and which is having low temperature effect and all. And mostly the external shunts are because of adding this external shunt resistance, the current carrying capability is improved, and the whenever the shunt resistance is added to the existing meter, even the whenever the external shunt resistor is added with respect to the working meter in a parallel manner, this DC ammeter PMMC instrument will read very large amount of currents. So is this concept of application of DC shunt resistor, is it clear? Coming into the next application, that is application of shunt resistance with respect to the multi-range. Multi-range in the sense, most of you people are familiar with starter, graded resistance or parted resistance. There is a resistance in starter, which is called as graded resistance or parted resistance. Most of you are familiar with that. So with the help of that graded resistance and parted resistance, we can connect the starter from starting position to final instant. So similarly in the concept of multi-range, similarly in the concept of multi-range meters, what we have to do means we have to switch the resistance. So in the previous concept, while application of shunt resistor, we used a single shunt resistance. So what we did means here, or later we evolved that single shunt resistance, and we used a series of shunt resistances. See, this R1 is one shunt resistance, and R2 is a shunt resistance, and R3 is a shunt resistance, and R4 is a shunt resistance. R4 is a shunt resistance. That means a unique number of shunt resistances are connected here. Okay. So it is a quite application with respect to the shunt resistance, but here we connected a series of parted resistances. That means what is the main purpose means here, an extension of number of shunts increases the range of the ammeter. Okay, the range of ammeter is improved by connecting this particular various resistances R1, R2, R3, R4. So whenever we need a specific range, we will tap on the particular resistor, or we can tap on R1. If we take an tap on R1, the DC ammeter range is fixed to up to a certain rating. If we tap on R2 with the help of range switch, the entire DC ammeter range will be switched to R2. If we tap on R3, DC ammeter range is switched to R3. If we tap on R4, DC ammeter range is switched to R4. That means multi-range ammeter is at this particular range is further exceeded with number of shunts. That means whenever we select a specific range, that resistance is added together in parallel to the working instrument, and entire range of the instrument will be improved. So that is the thing happening here. So this is about second application. First application we discussed, that is application of shunt resistance, and second application we are discussing, that is multi-range ammeter. And the third application, that is universal shunt. This is the third application, that is universal shunt or Aeron shunt. So what is an application of universal shunt and Aeron shunt? What is the main difference between shunt resistance and this universal resistance means? In shunt resistance, if we see, we used a single rated resistance which is connected in parallel to the working DC ammeter. Even in a multi-range ammeter, also we connected a series of parallel resistances which is connected next to the meter. But in Aeron shunt, what we did means we connected a series resistance bridge. See, R1 resistance is connected in series to R2. R2 resistance is connected in series to R3. That means a series resistance is connected together in parallel to the working DC ammeter instrument. That is called as universal shunt or Aeron shunt. That means this eliminates the possibility of having an instrument without the shunt. That means this resistance which is inbuilt connected with respect to the ammeter, so this gains the advantage. That means overall DC ammeter resistance is improved with a slightly higher rating. That means this improves the network topology, and this improves the resistance rating capability of an instrument. Entire resistance rating capability of an instrument is improved with this type of thing. Okay, so DC ammeter at this instant will improve the range from 20 milliamps to 50 amperes. This is very high range construction. For medium ranges and for small ranges, for a high ranges, if we use an external shunt, it can we use a self-contained meter. Self-contained meter, it can read up to 500 amperes. So this is a maximum rating we can suggest. That means, with respect to the application of this series resistance, which is connected in parallel to the working DMMC meter. So this type of mechanism is called as universal shunt or Atron shunt. Okay, if we connect the resistance, external resistance in this manner, the overall resistance of the meter is improved rapidly, and the network topology of the circuit is quite simple without any complexity. There is no switching here. So see here, in application of front resistor, we used a single meter. We used a single resistor. Later, we used a switching mechanism with the help of the range switch. Okay, and this type of range switches will create certain amount of thermal losses. So, in order to eliminate all these tedious issues, what we did means we connected a series resistance in a series resistance. R1 is connected in parallel in series to R2. R2 is connected in series to R3, and that entire resistance is connected in parallel to this particular meter. So if we connect this type of things, the thermal losses and heat losses and switching losses will be eliminated, and there will be a wide range of applications. Okay, the DC ammeter range can be exceeded rapidly. For a small ranges, it will read from 20 milliamperes to 50 milliamperes, from low ranges to mid ranges. For a full range of higher ranges, of it can read up to 500 amperes with the help of this particular external shunt or universal shunt. Okay, so this is about the three applications of DC ammeter range extension. First application, we discussed about application of shunt resistor, and next we discussed about simple multi-range ammeter, and next we discussed about the application of universal shunt or Atron shunt. So next we will see, so how this type of ammeter work, how can we choose an ammeter, or how does an ammeter has to be handled in a proper working condition. So first most important thing when we are selecting the ammeter for a working condition in a lab practice or whatever it may be, the research practice, when we are selecting an ammeter, first we have to check the polarity for measurement of DC currents. DC ammeter, the two PMMC instrument is quite good because it is having a uniform scale. It can read very even mild and very less amount of currents. Okay, checking of polarity is very, very important. If we have to check the polarity, means if it is an PMMC instrument, it will read only DC current, and the polarities will be positive and negative. And second one is selecting the range. First, we have to calculate the current rating. Depending upon the current rating, we have to select the range of the instrument. And second thing is, never connect the ammeter across to an EMF source. Most important rule, and this is a universal rule. Always we have to connect the ammeter in series. Because of the resistance rating, if we connect the ammeter in parallel to an EMF source or an voltage source, it will get shorted and it will be damaged. Okay, and the second thing is limited loading current with respect to the operation. And third important rule is while using a milli range meter, first we have to select very high current range, and then we have to decrease the current range. So foremost important thing what we have to see means we have to check the polarity. And second thing is, never connect the ammeter with respect to an EMF source in parallel. And for third most important rule is, while using the multi-range meter, first we have to check the higher current range. What is the highest current range? What will be the highest current range which is flowing through the line? And next we have to decrease the current range until the successive deflection which is going to obtain. So these are the three most important rules we have to follow whenever the ammeter is connected with respect to the working condition. Working condition. So next, what we have to see means next we have to see about we will discuss about DC voltmeter's extension range. Okay, PMMC instrument DC voltmeter, it will read only DC polarities. It will read DC polarities, and most important advantage what we got means the scale is uniform here, and it will read very it will even high amount of ratings up to 600 volts. And it can also read very less amount of very small amount of current voltage ratings also. So this is one of the important advantage which we got. This is one of the important advantage which we got with respect to the PMMC instrument DC voltmeter. So the PMMC instrument DC voltmeter is having this unique capability. Why I am keep on saying the unique capability means the scale representation. The scale is uniform. That makes the instrument. The scale is uniform. That makes the instrument quite simple, and that makes the implement the voltage reading capability and as well as the voltage sensing capability. Even in it is a very small amount of current also. Even it is a very small amount of current, it will read every instant at every instant. So we also know about the Dearsonal moment. Okay. So what is actually happens is the basic Dearsonal moment is converted in DC voltmeter by adding a series resistor or a multiplier. If we connected series resistor or a multiplier with respect to this particular meter of Dearsonal moment, what does that multiplier do means that multiplier which we connected here, this multiplier will limit the current flowing through the meter. Okay, it will limit the current flowing through the meter up to a particular full scale. Whenever there is a full scale deflection flowing through the meter, that means whenever this meter is getting a full scale deflection, after the meter getting the full scale deflection, the current is limited with respect to the multiplier. That means the deflection of this meter depending upon the usage of this multiplier. If we exceed the value of the multiplier, the voltage range will be exceeded. Okay, you are getting my point, right? So what we are doing here, or what we are seeing, what is seeing the instant means here. So in the concept of Dearsonal moment, what we are doing means in the concept of DC voltmeter, we are connecting a series resistance which is known as a multiplier. Okay, what does this multiplier do means always according to the electrical science, if we connect a resistor in series to the line, what is the property of resistance? Resistance will oppose the flow of current, right? So this resistor, which is called as multiplier, will oppose the flow of current whenever at what condition? Whenever this meter reaches a particular full scale deflection. What is full scale deflection? Our aim is to read 10 volts which is flowing in the line, and a voltmeter is connected across. So whenever the meter reads the reading of 10 volts, that is the full scale deflection. That means needle has to start from 0 volts and it has to read 10 volts. Okay, that needle traveling from 0 volts to 10 volts, that is called full scale deflection. The meter read its magnitude at a particular instant of time, that is called full scale deflection. Okay, so if we exceed this particular multiplier range, okay, the current, the voltage reading capability is improved up to 500 volts. So this is a quite larger range. This is a height quite larger range. So if we see the voltage, if we see the resistance rating of this particular meter, Im is nothing but current flowing with respect to the meter. Im is the total current flowing with respect to the meter. Rm is the resistance of the meter. Okay. And Rs is the series resistance which is flowing here. Rs is the series resistance. And total voltage is capital V. Okay. So total capital V, if we see the capital V with respect to the Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. V is equal to IR. Here, what is I? I is nothing but total main current flowing in the line, I into R. How can we split the R? Resistance of the multiplier, that is R suffixes, which is connected in series to the meter. Meter is having some resistance, that is R sub xm, that is represented with respect to V is equal to Im into R, capital Rs plus Rm. Okay. So if we represent that in the terminal of Rs, Rs is equal to V minus Im into Rm divided by Im. Okay. This is how the resistance rating of the instrument is explained. So if we see the next evolution, first we discussed about application of multiplier with respect to the DC voltmeter, and next we will see the application of multi-range voltmeter. So how can we connect a multi-range voltmeter means, so similar to the concept of multi-range ammeter, if we go to the concept of multi-range ammeter, what we did, we connected a series number of shunt resistances with respect to the meter, directional moment. With the help of a range switch, we selected the required range. So similarly, similar thing is happened with respect of this multi-range voltmeter. In this multi-range voltmeter also, if we connect the series resistance, so R1 is a series resistance which is connected in series to R2, R2 is a resistance which is connected in series to R3, R3 is a resistance which is connected next to series R4. So this is R1, R2, R3, R4. Four resistances are connected in series. At each resistor point, we connected a stud node. See, this is one, V1 is one stud, V2 is one stud, V3 is one stud point, V4 is one stud point. Four points are connected here, and individual point is tapped with the help of a range switch. This is nothing but our range switch. So with the help of this particular range switch, whenever we need the resistance rating, we will select on the particular resistance rating, and that resistance rating is observed with the help of this particular range switch. That means if we tap on this point of V1, R1 is a resistance flowing. If we tap on V2, initial resistance is R2. If we tap on V3, combined resistance R1 and R2 is flown with respect to line 3. If we tap on V4, R1 plus R2 plus R3 will flow with respect to R4. That means a series resistance is combined together and it is added to the resistance. Okay. So this is how a series of resistances, which is called as a series of multipliers, which are connected. And these are all formed together and form a standard resistances. So the entire application is evolved with the help of this particular range switch. That means a multi-range voltmeter is allowed here by adding a series range of resistances in the form of multipliers, which are connected together at a particular appropriate range. So what these are various advantages. One of the main advantages here, the standard resistance rating of a voltmeter is improved. Whenever the standard resistance rating of voltmeter is improved, means in DC voltmeter of a PMMC instrument, the range will be improved, the range will be segregated. Okay, up to 500 amperes, up to 500 volts, it will read up to 500 volts. And second thing is, after tapping with respect to R4 at very last instant, it can read very low amount of voltage also. That means PMMC instrument is having a uniform scale. It will read very small voltage and next to the highest voltage rating also. So that is one of the advantage. If we extend the range with respect to DC voltmeter, which is our PMMC instrument, and we discussed about the concept of multiplier application with respect to DC voltmeter, and next we discussed about multi-range voltmeter. Loading effect of voltmeter. So how can we discuss the loading effect of voltmeter means? So the resistance rating of voltmeter is not very, very high. As we see, we are connecting a series multiplier, that indicates the resistance rating of voltmeter is not very, very high as we compared. So even though the resistance rating is very, very less, so you can measure a particular unique amount of voltage. So there is a particular sensitivity with respect to the voltage input. That means the whenever the input resistance is improved, there is a chance of increasing sensitivity and there is a chance of increasing loading effect. Okay, so this chance of loading effect is caused because of voltmeter loads, which are a circuit which is connected across. That means the loading effect can be minimized by using a voltmeter with an improved resistance, by increasing the rating of resistor or by increasing the rating of multiplier. We can improve the loading effect across the thing. So if we improve the rating of the resistor, the loading effect will be eliminated, and that causes the voltmeter and that operates the voltmeter quite effectively. That means the accuracy of the instrument and sensitivity of the instrument can be improved by changing the loading effect by changing the loading effect, which depending upon the rating of the voltmeter. So in today's class, that is about loading effect of voltmeter. In today's class, we discussed about the application DC ammeter range extension, that is application of shunt resistor, and multi-range ammeter and universal shunt, and multi-range voltmeter and loading effect. So we discussed about the application of shunt resistance. If we connect a shunt resistance here with respect to the dearsenal moment, what is meant by dearsenal moment? Current reading capability of an instrument or voltage reading capability of an PMMC instrument is called as dearsenal moment. So if we connect a resistance in parallel to the dearsenal moment, the entire current reading range of an ammeter will be improved. We observed the numerical calculation, and next we discussed about the what is the purpose of these external shunts and all. And next we also discussed about simple multi-range ammeter. Okay, how a multi-range ammeter is constructed? A multi-range ammeter is constructed by connecting a series number of parallel resistances. So this is an R1, R2, R3, R4. These four parallel resistances are connected in parallel to this meter. While selecting the range switch, we can improve the value of resistance, and meter resistance will be improved. And next we will discuss about universal shunt in the sense this is a complex which is based on the application of shunt resistor. But how the shunt resistance is connected? A series resistance R1, R2, R3, which is connected in parallel to the shunt resistor. So that is how an universal shunt or R1 shunt is evolved. And we discussed about what is the objective and what is the main advantage. If we connect this type of shunt resistance, what will happen? The current carrying capability and as well as the, even it can read the mild amount of currents, and even it can read very large amount of currents. We discussed that. And next we discussed about the application of multiplier in a PMMC instrument with respect to DC voltmeter. And next we discussed about multi-range voltmeter. And next we also analyzed about loading effect of DC voltmeter. I hope it's clear. What is that? Come again. How an universal shunt or R1 shunt is connected. So universal shunt or R1 shunt is connected in a similar manner of connecting shunt resistance. That's what I'm saying. So see, if we see in this particular figure, a series resistance, right? R1 is resistance, and R2 resistance is connected in series to R1. R3 resistance is connected in series to R1 and R2. So this series resistance is connected in parallel to the meter resistance. Okay, R1 resistance is having a current rating of 10 amperes. R2 resistance is having a current rating of 5 amperes. R3 resistance is having a current rating of 1 ampere. If we select on individual tapping, the actual current rating can be selected. So this is an entire completely different thing. When we compare with the shunt resistance, in shunt resistance we don't discuss about the rating of current after tapping with respect to the range switch. Even in the multimeter, even the multi-range meter also, if we select on the particular resistance, the entire resistance of the rating is improved. That's what we said. But current carrying capability, we didn't discuss that. But here in the concept of universal shunt, at individual resistance, we already plotted this is the amount of current rating. This is the current rating with respect to R2. This is the current rating with respect to R3. That means the extension of range is already prescribed here. By selecting on that particular tab, the actual current rating of the meter will be specified clearly. Okay, is that clear? Right. Anyone is having any doubt? That multi-range ammeter, how can we connect a multi-range voltmeter? Okay, multi-range voltmeter means simple. We are talking about multimeter, we are talking about multiplier, right? Multiplier is nothing but a series resistance which is next connected to the meter, in series to the meter. So similar to that multiplier, we are connecting n number of multipliers. Depending upon the application, we can connect two multipliers. Depending upon multiplier in the sense, a series resistance connected to the meter. So depending upon the application, we can connect four multipliers or three multipliers. That's why I said, how you asked the very question, how many number of multipliers we will connect in a multi-range voltmeter. Depending upon the application, that's why I said n number of resistors. We can connect four, or we can connect three, or we can connect five, depending upon the application and depending upon the range extension. Okay. Right, anyone? Thank you, everyone. Thank you for your time.